Brainwash 444, Heather Ann McGaw Blessington. This looks so incognito. I like it. So during the break, if you missed part one, we're talking about Blackstone operations. Why? Because Blackstone owns us. They own the world. So let's start out with this. Hey, gang. Who knows what the symbol is, gang? So see this name on here, Zilkey? It's a really, really close to what my family... Actually, let me take a card out. So my uncle, who I'm starting to think... Is this a Kazarian thing? Like, everyone's saying Russian mob. But is this the Kazarian situation? Who knows these symbols? Tell me on Telegram. Is this thing upside down? Hang on. Okay, this is the weirdest story of these cards, okay? Honestly... As you get into this, and by the way, the topic of today is Blackstone Part 2. Like, serious intel on how we're going to take down trafficking across the world. That's what we're talking about, but first. Weirdo story. This weird deck of cards. Look at how creepy and strange it is. So you should look up this. You should, I mean, everything. See this? Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Yet again. What are these symbols? They're not random. It's not random. This is close to my uncle's name. If not, I think that's how he spelled it, or close. Just like McGaw. My name is McGaw, not McGraw. That's what they do. They just... What are these symbols? Okay. So, let's talk about Blackup. Yeah, Blackstone Operations. See that computer over there? Tried to set it up and it died. That's my son's computer that I've been dragging with me for 2 years. I've attempted to plug it in multiple times. We used it up in Ripon, and now it's just been sitting here, and I thought, okay, I'm going to show them this birth canal topography thing. Apparently, I'm not supposed to show you that because maybe you guys aren't ready for it or something. Maybe you're not following me. I don't know. Okay, regardless, let's just set the stage. So the reason I showed you those cards is because part of my goal is I'm unraveling my family mystery behind all this, okay? And Zilkey was my uncle that came strolling in on the German side of the family. Mr. Moneybags, multimillionaire, you know, running multiple different laundromats, different auto parts crap down in Arkansas, okay? Giving everybody jobs. I mean, it's just, he's the center point. That's why I care about that dude. Two, I'm trying to figure out who's the core thing, like... They talk about these Kazarians, Benjamin Fulford, so we talk about whatever. We don't really care. They're just a group of insane pedophile people that are just not going to stop. They're like animals, okay? They're not like us. There will be no trials. No one's coming to save us. And through this whole freaking thing breaking down, we're going to come back in our power and be like, holy shit, we broke down the sex trafficking thing. We didn't need a military. Nothing. We had a disabled lady leading us. And a bunch of other women and men from all around the world that just freaking went outside their door to Extended Stay America parking lot to take down Blackstone. That's how easy this shit should be, okay? Okay, so I was essentially stationed by the Lord at Extended Stay America Brookfield, in which we went into in depth on part one. Why? So I could be on the third floor undercover and up in the corner and catch every freaking thing these mobsters were doing, okay? And I contend that Extended Stay America, okay, we went through the structure of the hotels. It's very critically important because think about this logically, you guys. This is just like me trying to say, let's get reach on the internet. You can stay in your echo chamber world and pretend you're doing something, or you can logically freaking think through this and be like, unless I get reach beyond my network, I'm doing nothing but entertaining myself and making myself feel better. About a little network that I'm not helping because we're not going to get out of this echo chamber. We're going to actually stay in it and blab about nothing and talk about stars and hardy har har until the freaking doorbell rings and they take you. So that's yet another PSYOP layer that you guys on IG that, you know, I need you over here. I need you on Telegram as my main channel and we need to freaking get real. You need to all get off your butts. The Lord did not station me at Extended Stay America, have Blackstone's freaking buy them out, have me kick my ass. I'm going to tell you the story of what they freaking went through, sent in four different departments to take me down, and this is Waukesha County. Do you see how this is all coming together? They did not have me in Waukesha County with them trying to take me down, these cops, and then have the Waukesha County parade occur. This whole thing is planned so far in advance, it's ridiculous. And my job is to dump all this to you in a way that you can comprehend it and then give you action. But you've got to take it. Like, how hard is it to get in your. I don't know why I'm yelling. I'm yelling because I'm sick of this shit and I'm tired. My body hurts as usual. So, how hard is it to just go get in your car? There's 650 hotels and go in a parking lot and see everything I'm saying. It's not hard at all. So, you guys are going to do it. Plus, teenagers. If I was a teenager right now, I would be so freaking into the story. I'd be like, wait a minute. This lady's saying that extended stay America, and I go into details part one. You're telling me that extended stay America painted 650 hotels with all the west walls red. Because they're psychopaths that want to kill everybody? Yes. You're telling me that in the lobby of every extended stay hotel is a freaky, weird, Greek-looking gold head that's like a door knocker on a red door with the number 4? Yes. You're telling me that every laundry room of extended stay America has mounted on the red, creepy, bloodish wall a key that has a number. It's 89 something, and I can't remember the rest. Yes. Okay. So we have identical designed hotels. Yes. Also, blatant trafficking, blatant cops part of it, blatant tons of cars in the parking lot with no license plates. How can that be? Well, the girl Colombo said that what they do is they partner with the auto dealers, so they all get cars. So they give cars to the pimps and the handlers. The handlers, what do they look like? Rich whiteys, like the lady you're looking at. They don't look like some dirtball from a faraway land. No, they look like a rich whitey pimping out their tween girls for blowjobs on the front bench. Got it. Okay, so anybody who shows up at Extended Stay America can see blatant trafficking of all kinds. Yes, positive. Go at night for even more fun. Why? Because they tool around and around the parking lot around. Oh, and it's winter, Wisconsin? They don't quit in winter. They go around around the building, around around the building, around the building. Cops could, cops come too. Yeah, no one ever gets arrested. But the cops are whirling and twirling too. Oh, they're here to, you know, protect, right? So we leave the downstairs door open, so the people that get the free cars from the dealerships and work at Aldi because they're given a job as well. They can show up at night after their shift, just walk in the door, get their room, and then they have their gift cards that they bought their food with, and then they can pay if they're pimping out themselves, whatever they pay with gift cards. That's the whole operation. So Blackstone has this operation. This is just the sex part. I'm just getting going. They're trafficking blood, organs. They're hauling out dead bodies. Okay? It's that bad. You guys, it's a movie. It's like, I mean, I would be there alone. Just honestly, it was fun. The undercover shit was fun. I was just like, it would be like I'm in bed. I told a few stories in the part one, but when I found them dumping the water supply, I found a backpack in the hallway of like two pockets. It's like wide open, sitting in the hallway at 2 in the morning. Here's all the gift cards that are used. Here's the gifts that aren't. And the backpack's just in the hallway. So what are they? You go in there, give your blowjob, come out, done. I mean, that's what they're doing. And then on every, we have 650 hotels throughout the United States of America, just bought out by Blackstone. Really, don't even think called a monopoly. So Blackstone already owns 80% of the entire hotel universe, but we're gonna give them the other what, 20%? So they did. So think about this. Yeah, we have a real good system. Blackstone, you already own all Marriott's, all Hilton, all Wyndham, and then we're gonna give you ESA. And then you're going to be allowed to have 650 hotels with only security cameras on the lower floor, a false sense of security. Doors are wide open, come and go as you please. And the second and third floor, where all the rapes occur and the child birthday parties and the cops' little hangout, is the second and third floor. Yeah, that's why when you have Blessington there screaming and hollering, can we get cameras? Can we get cameras? Can I have the Wi-Fi password to set up my own password? Begging and hollering? Yeah. They don't answer, they kick your ass out. Look, I'm going to tell you what they did. So this was months, you guys, of insanity. I'm not, in part one, I just talked about, the videos are so good. I'll eventually get my channel back, okay? It's complete chaos. I was just, I was tearing that place apart. They were freaking. They were just like, get her the F out of here. But you have to understand this. Sequence of events are this. I paid for months on end. Their water was poisoned. I caught them dumping. They weren't helping me. Other people were coming to me with rashes, throwing up, sick. Old ladies freaking disappear. Where'd that lady go? I don't know. I mean, I'm helping people move into the first floor because, you know, God forbid anybody at home, Emily and staff down there can even help anybody. No. They just sit at the front desk with poison water and watch a 52-year-old woman get the cart and haul those huge jugs of water up to the third floor by herself while they're at the desk. They are animals. And there's people that work at that front desk that are freaking awesome, and they're stuck there with these monsters. They're stuck there. They enter the rooms at night. These people do whatever the hell they want to do. They're guided by somebody. They're demon people. They're demon freaking people. They allow all this shit with the cops. So just mark my words, you guys. People are disappearing, okay? This place was this out of control. This is how out of control it would be. I'm just trying to, like, go outside to, like, chill out and breathe. No. We're on the third floor, and we have to encounter a drunk, old, white, rich couple that look like your average grandma and grandpa. The grandpa is wasted. He's carrying a birthday gift. The mom is holding the hand of a little girl in, like, a princess costume, and the gift is wrapped in panda wrapping paper. They're ripped. It was entertainment. I mean, I was just like, okay. So you're going to have all these kids' birthday parties on these upper floors and we have no cameras. Then, constantly, two little, beautiful, adorable twin black girls in matching lavender coats and hoods with a really fancy, well-dressed nanny lady. Older, kind of from like Jamaica or somewhere, like an accent lady. More melanated, dark, which treated the kids super good. Like, doted on them. It wasn't like, oh, hey, there's... No, it was like, this lady, they up back and forth. Tons of teenage, really melanated kids from Dominican Republic with really fancy designer clothes that I'd never seen these designer before. Always in, like, super sharp dress. I mean, where are you guys going? Buses coming and going? I told the story in the first one, but I want to reiterate how asinine this is, okay? So on top of all this insane sex trafficking action going on, you know, tween blowjobs in the front hall, Emily going into the rooms, me literally seeing people dumping in the back. I mean, it's an insane asylum at this point, okay? Oh! I had this on video. On top of it, they cannot do the basics. The fire alarm keeps going off. To the point I wiped out in the parking lot trying to get out one morning. You guys, it's an insane asylum. And they kept coming back to fix the elevator, and then off it goes. So you wake up scared shitless of a huge fire alarm. Then there's no notification. They'll be like, oh, sorry, we were testing. It's like, can you put a note on the door and tell us? Then they say, oh, we just had this thing. We're going to have to come in your room, by the way, and test it. They never come. They never, after fire alarm, swear to God. Everyone in the hotel had to come out. We're all in the parking lot. They never did an announcement to tell us what happened. They never gave a note. Nothing. It's literally a gym with kids running it, with a person like Emily, a black magic person who's on drugs or something, going into the veterans' rooms. Oh, I got to tell my friend the vet story. So this is why this business model works. It's because people that are down and out stay there. People like me who are hunted on the run. I looked like a battle axe, okay? My buddy's my age, younger, actually. He's only like 40, looked way older. Total vet. Gave me so much military intel. Rich family, again. Parents didn't want him at their mansion, you know, because he's a drunk. Because he's in a ton of freaking pain. Because he can't get into the doctor to get his shoulder fixed. So the guy's drinking, okay? That's what he's doing. We're trying to get him to the doctor. His mommy's paying for his room, so he does not have the mansion, you know, messing up the Pewaukee Lake Country mansion 5 minutes away. No, we can't have our son there. We're going to pay $50-$60 a night to have our son over here, and there's this medicine lady that's just taking care of him, okay? So he kept calling me because they took him in for surgery and couldn't get him back in. And he's in so much pain, okay? So he's just boozing it up down there. And he's got this arm thing on. And he kept calling to say, Heather, can you help me with my arm thing? So I'd go down there. Well, all of a sudden he's called me. He's like, he's just like, dude, you're not going to believe this. And I hadn't been in his room, okay? He's a private man downstairs. Like, he's on the first floor, right? He's like, they came in my room last night. I'm like, what? He's like, yeah, she was looking for that oil you gave me. And I'm like, what? So I'm like, tell me what's going on. Here, I'll show you. So their idea was, let's get Heather. She's dealing out of this place. They thought I'm like cannabis dealing, right? I'm going to show you what I was giving him. Okay, at this point, I'm broke as a freaking joke, okay? I'm down to my few $1,000s, which I'm saving. I make my oil, and from my oil, which is like the ridiculous lowest THC ever, here's the grinds that are left over. You can use them as chew. And I give them to homeless people. So I gave him a jar. Because if you suck on them long enough, like, you'll have calming effects. Grounds. You couldn't squeeze THC out of here if you tried. Okay? It has like a CBD effect is what it has. So I gave him grounds. Well, then he was really into it. And he was just a nice guy. I'm like, all right, you want to try essential oils? He's like, sure. So I gave him this little roller jar. This little roller thing. Here, I'll show you. And I just put all these calming, relaxing things. I'm like, all right. In light of the fact that you're in so much freaking pain, it might not do jack shit, but just try it, okay? So here, I make these. This is for mosquito bites. I made him one, and I put a cute label on there, like, whatever it's for pain, right? Well, then he's into it, and he starts dipping his cigarettes in here. He's like, hey, I've been dipping my cigarettes in there. Comes in, I'm like, whatever works. It's like, you know, whatever works. That manager, Emily, entered his room on the first floor. So the footage is there, cops of the universe, if anyone cares to freaking listen. So seeing that I dumped the story 87 times. This is all he had, you guys. It was like eucalyptus, lavender, frankincense, and whatever. So, Emily, what'd you do? Did your corrupt mobster bosses told you, bust into that dude's room, she gave him drugs, and you're going to go sneak into a vet's room because you think he's too drunk to notice. Scare him. He woke up. He said he woke up, and he was like, what are you doing? And she was just, she's an idiot. Okay, so Emily, did you and your little copsters, you stole it. You stole his oil. Are you going to come arrest me for my eucalyptus frankincense mix? This is how asinine the world is there. And every time I'd leave my room, I'd barely leave because they wouldn't redo my key. I was like, I'm going to be locked out if I leave. And again, paid for months on end, saw dumping, was working with the general manager, Tyler Manny. The head of investor relations, Rob Ballew, has multiple phone calls for me, multiple emails. Every email, you guys, I'm a PMP. That's a project manager. Every email I sent to Manny, all you got to do is look at extended stay database. They track everything. I was on him constantly. I'm like, Tyler, people are sick. They're dumping. Here's the video I put on YouTube. Here's the kicker that's critically important, though. I could blab about all this shit. I mean, this is just entertainment at this point. Here's the kicker that's important, okay? They put you through all this and then they deny due process. So in what I'm going to tell you right here is why I'm telling mothers who don't have your kids back and other people that are out here saying, I'm going to go by the book and start a, you know, nonprofit organization for survivors. This is why I'm like, no, 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 no. Guys, you cannot in any sense be part of their system because what they did to me here, the way they got it to where they evicted me out of there and they sent six cops to try to take me down is they sent me a notice for a hearing when I stop paying. That's due process. I'm like, beautiful. I'm going to go to this hearing. And I went online to the Waukesha County Courts and I went to look it up and it wasn't in their system. And I was like, this is a setup. There is no way in hell I'm going to Waukesha. You guys, Waukesha Courthouse is so freaking scary. It's like Transylvania up there. Literally. I always think of Transylvania. I don't know why. Because Judge Afritamian's in there. The one who scheduled, had to reschedule my divorce the day after Valentine's Day because he couldn't do it on Valentine's Day. And then during my divorce, in which I was sitting there, I could barely even get my clothes on because they were beaming with me with an energy weapon so much. And my skin hurt. He went into a 5-minute diatribe with my now ex-husband about the Bodines at Summerfest. In the middle of a divorce hearing. You guys don't think MK Ultra's going on. I'm sitting in my nightmare divorce, my whole, it's the day after Valentine's Day. This creepy ass, look him up, Judge Michael Afritamian. He looks like a warlock from hell, and he's engaging in a conversation with the who was my love of my life, who now freaking hates me and thinks I'm insane, and they're talking about the Bodines. Can you imagine me in this? I'm like, what's going on? He's the heart of it. Him and Sheriff Severson are the heart of this freaking thing. And this Waukesha parade is just getting started. They are not going to let... We're going to have to fight to get this Waukesha town. Because this is like a global asset hub is what it is. This is so much bigger than me. They just wanted... They did not want me. An Epstein child model traffic survivor with a huge mouth that grew up there. Digging into all the shit. And when I discovered the water... I mean, this is really about the water. Is that what I should be talking about? The water. Yeah. Hang on. I just want to make this... What's going to make you guys take action? I feel like no one's taking action because you're either scared, you don't know what to do. Well, I've already given you action. All right. I just got to get the story out on extended stay. And if I get into the... The point I want to make is this. Before I tell the story. This was about multiple things. Me being Epstein traffic survivor. Me with a big mouth camping out there for 6 months. Refusing to pay because their water's freaking poison. Me going to the town board hearing. Town board meeting. And they're talking about painting the Monsanto. I call it Monsanto. Logo on the water towers. Do you understand how big this is? Okay. I don't know what they're pouring in the water. But if it was like mind control or what. Look this up for me. Peshtigo, Wisconsin, $17 million lawsuit. Earlier this year or late last year, they found this chemical from Tyco, which they claim to be, were the fire department and were spraying this stuff during fires. It's from Tyco, okay? Tyco is owned by Johnson and Controls. Not Johnson & Johnson. Johnson Controls. They paid out $17 million to this itty bitty town in Wisconsin, Peshtigo, because that chemical got into the groundwater accidentally and started killing people. I contend it's throughout the state, if not nationwide, and it was purposeful. And that's how they got the chemicals into our water. And now, I don't know, what are we not dying fast enough? So you just got some dude behind Extended Stay America in Brookfield with huge blue buckets on top of the freaking hill at 5 o'clock in the freaking morning next to a business that has no markings and nobody to call, no door to open, nothing. You're dumping blue buckets of clear material down the hill into Extended Stay America where everyone's dying and Heather's there? And it's eating away her clothes? You guys, I was hand washing my clothes with a filter. They were just little cheap Walmart tanks. No way. You guys, one wash, they'd be falling apart. My food would rot so fast. I had all the videos. They're all gone. I would buy cheese. You know how cheese could last months? Within a week, completely green. Wash my dishes. There would be these granules, these black granules. I mean, they have a multi-tiered approach to kill you there. If you land there, you're dead. Yeah, you're dead. So, let's get also into the type of people that work Extended Stay. It's the down and outers, the vet people that nobody wants, people like me, okay? Deadbeats over here. Then we have healthcare people from multiple states to work at St. Francis Hospital. So they were all from, the melanated dudes were from Georgia that came up for jobs to work in Allenton, which was asinine. Freaking asinine. In no universe does it make sense. Oh, hi, this is what we're going to do. This is our business model. Yeah, we're in the middle of a pandemic. Okay. Apparently, we can't find any highly melanated black dudes in Milwaukee, even though they're full of them and nobody's got anything to do and they're sitting on the porch. But what we're going to do is we're going to hire a bunch of really black melanated dudes from Georgia. We're going to pay to have them live up here. We're going to have them pay to live at Extended Stay. And then we're going to pay to put them all on a white shuttle bus for second shift up to Allenton, 45 minutes away, to work their freaking metal work shift, work warehouse, whatever they're doing, and to come back to Extended Stay. That's not a business model that works ever. The guys knew it. They became my buddies. I was like, you guys, what the hell? They're like, I'm like, this ain't right. So we were working on that shit too. They're just going to kill these people. I think they're siphoning their blood. So every night I'd look out the window and see my buddies go off second shift. Yeah. To really, really nice guys. Really good people. They don't think they have any choice. They're like, you know what? I had nothing. What am I going to do? They offer me, what are you going to do? Yeah. Well, they want your blood. Dude, you're worth $10 million dead. So if they can keep you alive, siphon you up at Allenton or whatever the F they're doing. And no, they don't just auto, like, go, oh, hey, guys, come up here. No. You work for 6 months. They treat you nice. They give you benefits. Oh, this hotel's nice. You got food. You got plenty of, you got your whole setup. Now, we're launching a new healthcare plan, and can you donate blood weekly? That's it. You're a slave. You guys were livestock in their system. This place is set up black magic on a level you can't frickin' imagine. It's mind-boggling. It sounds fantastical and crazy. I'm here to tell you, it's beyond what I'm telling you. Right next door is Master Z's. Behind Master Z's is Blair Witch Project. That was these creepy witchy-looking sticks about 20 feet in the air. And after I shot the video, they're breaking it all down a few days later. And then busted me when I came back. And Penzies is back there whipping up spices in the creepy-ass building. Wake up, Brookfield! It's sick. You guys, Brookfield, these people sit around and pay $500,000 to $1 million for a house for this shit. And you're all a freaking pickin' slave over there getting your water? Why don't you ask these people what they're doing with your money? The most important takeaway from this discussion is, A, you getting an action I've just given you in your hometown, I guarantee you there's an extended stay. Will you please, if you purport to care about the children, go take a drive-thru with your hubby. There's nothing to be freaking scared of. Please. And will you look for cars in the parking lot with outdated plates? Will you look for curtains tied back with bandanas or balloons like a birthday party with maybe numbers or colors on it? It's all signs. Will you walk inside and just pretend you want to know rates and freaking look around and be like, this place is Creepsville. Why is there a number 4 Greek looking gold head door knocker there? Then just peek in the laundry thing. It's right there, right when you walk in. Every extended stay, same place. West wall will be red, and there's a number on the key. Somebody can give it to me in Telegram if you go. It's 89 something. It means something. Geminatra or something. It's not that hard. Every room has a red door, like the Truman Show. Like, walk through the door, but it's death door. Right there. So you can just take a stroll through and see what I'm talking about. That's creepy. That's one of the creepiest things I've ever heard. I can't believe they take it that far, can you? Okay, relative to Brookfield. But what's important is, this is important to me, because I'm bored with blabbing about this stuff. I got to make it relative to you, or just whatever. It's just whatever. I get it. I got to spit this out as my testimony, but I want to give people stuff that matters. Okay, here's a piece that matters. Let me just finish Brookfield. Brookfield birth canal, because I can't get my fucking computer going, okay? There's birth canals, literally. And I contend under the earth of these birth canals is probably crystal and all this stuff. This is how sick these people are. This is relative to topography, and the king of topography is Brooklyn Guru. So he's Brooklyn underscore Guru underscore 17 underscore BU on IG. I send him all my topography stuff, and he sends me stuff back. He's a Navy dude, okay? So he's got all these other programs. Topography just means you're looking at a map from above. You guys, they built into this. He's found all this stuff. Adam, Eve, we found a white rabbit up in freaking Ripon where the bones were. You're telling me where I find the freaking Shimura human animal bones mixed together. I finally get around to sending this to Brooklyn Guru. We're looking at it. I'm like, dude, is that a rabbit? Yeah, I put it on my Telegram. So where they have the topography, where that means like the trees and everything looking from above, it looks like a white rabbit where I found the bone. Come on. And then, you know, it's so weird. We were freaking out. This is just like Holly Baglow has 444 in her stuff, and I'm 444 just because I like the freaking number. That's why I picked it. I like 41444. That's why I picked it. This is so dumb. So she's got 444. You guys, where the bones are, where I'm telling, it's called Lark Lane, okay? It's supposed to be in Ripon, which is the birthplace of the Republican Party, which is where they do the hunting parties, okay? Follow me. I went there for the healing center. I find the bones. When you look it up on Google Maps, it says Brooklyn. And I sent it to Brooklyn Guru. I'm like, dude. So that leads to sister cities. I'm just not going to worry about staying on track. I think whatever you're supposed to pick up here, you're going to pick up. But your job is to take action, okay? Your job is to not watch these cue boards and watch me and watch all that and just, oh, this is interesting. No, you're not going to sit here and be interested in this freaking story until they ring your freaking doorbell, okay? We need to take this shit down so quarantine never freaking happens because they don't get to that stage, okay? So you're saving your own life by you helping me, by getting your butt out there, extending to America. Super easy thing to do, super fun, take some pictures, entertain your friends, send a message to Shane Dawson and tell him to shove it up his ass because I gave it to him. Again, these people are idiots, okay? Shane, you're the biggest idiot on the planet, okay? If you wanted to stay on your little hearty har har over there with Rylan, I mean, I'm just over these fucking people, but I gotta say this. Dude, all you had to do is listen to me. I sent Shane Dawson so much intel, just like David Rodriguez, all these people. They have it all. They're all criminals, crimes against humanity, done. I'm feeding to you information about how they're killing multiple people, they're traveling. We don't care. Because me and Rylan are going shopping tomorrow. You're sick, dude. You're sick. Your name is Yaw. The reason why you're overweight is because you're stuck under. You don't know who you are. Your name is Yaw. Why does Shane Dawson's mom call him Yaw? Y-A-W. Because he could have been a freaking elder, smart leader, dude. But he chose to be a hibernating bear, filling his face, and just being a gross pervert. That's the story of Shane Dawson. Okay, so carrying on. Brookfield, largest commercial real estate company in the world, not random, in sleepy little Brookfield, Waukesha County. So Waukesha County, where the parade happened, is Brookfield, where I grew up, where they placed me, New Berlin, where I raised my kids, neighboring, a perfect 6x6 square, according to GQ magazine, really. Why would GQ magazine write a story about New Berlin? And in Wikipedia it says, so-and-so from Rolling Stone said, New Berlin is a perfect 6x6 square. Why? Because it's the New Berlin. And that story was written because we had a thing called sextortion. I think maybe they coined the phrase. Yeah. So Rolling Stone wrote the article about New Berlin because that was the beginning of the pedophile invasion that came with Superintendent Warlock from Hell, 400-pound monster, Joseph Garza. I laugh because my son played baseball with his son, and I love his kids. And they slept at my house, and I took them to golf outings, and I knew his wife. And I'm not trying to hurt any of you, but your time is up. Your father is a monster. He did not probably know what he's getting into because he's too freaking stupid. But I know this much. Your father was a normal-sized human being when he got married, and now he's about 400 pounds, blowing up like a balloon. Look at him. Look up Superintendent Joseph Garza. Because I've been calling his ass out for years. And so Superintendent Joseph Garza has from me, dating back to, I believe, 2017, forewarning them of this, what is occurring. Because, you know, he was lucky enough to have a seer in his backyard who took care of his children. So I told Joseph Garza that Google is the NSA, and I had grand concerns that all the kids were on Chromebooks. This is about 5 years ago, Joe. Remember that? Yep. So, Joe, when you've got a female executive that just rang the bell on NASDAQ and that was just featured on the Milwaukee Journal for cybersecurity and her expertise, perhaps you should listen. When she sends you a Gmail out of the goodness of her heart, Joe, to tell you that the kids are in danger. And that perhaps you should check on the Chromebooks because it tracks the iris of their eye. And the iris of your eye is your real social security number. And Google is the NSA. Perhaps you all should have listened, boys, because then Joe won't listen. So then I sent it to, who's that? Geminiani, Mr. Fancy? Kevin Geminiani? You didn't listen either. I can't remember all the counselors' names there. None of you guys listened either. Then I went to the director of athletics. My 7-foot-tall son was on varsity. At this point, I'm an insane person and everybody hates me. I've been chased out of town and Garza hit me with an energy weapon first. Got me out of town. And by the way, this is in collusion with Judge Afrotamium in Waukesha County. Unless we get rid of these people, Waukesha County's gonna freaking blow again. And Mayor Ament, who's been there for decades, who his wife, Peggy, runs City Hall as the gatekeeper. And Ament, who his father ran Milwaukee, did a pension scam, ripped everybody off. So then we put his son in New Berlin with Peggy to gatekeep, yelling at me on Facebook, defending her husband that can't even get the freaking garbage picked up. And then their son's a cop. And we got 400-pound guards over there dancing around, trying. Joe, you're going to continue to blow up like a freaking balloon until you explode, like that Violet girl on Willy Wonka. And we're going to watch you and love every minute. And I have so much evidence on you, dude, because your wife told me a lot of shit that she shouldn't have. I know about Mexico, Joe. I know. So we're going to stop there because I love your children. But Joe, you're going to surrender and you're going to figure out a way to do it like now. Because you know what Joe did? Here's what we need in New Berlin. We need Miss Amy Crosby to take over. She should have been the superintendent to begin with. Oh, she happens to be recovering from a very serious... She had a... Really? Amy Crosby had to learn to walk and talk again. Really? After Heather got chased out of the Weatherstone neighborhood, her one few friend in the world left in the neighborhood, who happens to be the president of the school board, the right-hand person to Superintendent Joseph Garza, she is not even 50, athletic, healthy, Girl Scout leader with Heather Blessington. The president of the school board went down to the level she had to be multiple... She had to be in the hospital for months to learn to walk and talk. That's what's going on in perfect 6x6 square New Berlin. So now what these boys have set up is a fake quarantine center in your old FEMA Walmart on National Avenue. Again, I risked my life going on at least a year ago, if not two, to walk into your little fake Burkhart's sports complex on National to show all of you. Did you do anything? No. Why? Because all the dads wanted to take their kids to Burkhart's and buy a new $400 bat, even though we have a few in the garage, to do batting cages on the weekends. It's fun. So we're not going to listen to Heather. That's not a FEMA camp. You're insane. Behind your Burkhart's FEMA camp, since no one's listened to me, this is an 800,000 square foot Walmart that they're pretending is batting cages for Burkhart's. Why? Because they all love Burkhart's. Oh, and right down the road, this Ament character that I just told you about, he just approved another sports complex, but we call this, I'm not kidding you, it's on the City of New Berlin website if anyone cares to look. And this, you guys, extrapolate this out to your neighborhood, because I'm telling you, the takeaway for you right now is to listen to this and go to your city website and look at what I'm talking about. Every building, every time they build something, approve anything, it has to go on that website. That's how I found all the shit out way before they even built it. So we got Burkhart's, 800,000 square feet old Walmart sitting there. But we're not going to talk because all the dads are just in their ego mode and they just live for Burkhart's, okay? Sponsors every team, just we're in Lake Country, we're just fancy, okay? I'm not exaggerating, 2 miles down the road. Similar size, if not bigger. Brand new. They're calling it an ethnic sports complex. A, we're in Whitey, Bill. Who's ethnic? What are we going to do? We're putting Mexican, Indian people, whatever, over here in the ethnic one, and then over here the Whiteys are going? Is this the bloodline kids get the batting cages and over? You guys, the devil is building around you. I'm over here going, hi, hi. These people won't listen. 2 years I drove around. You guys, extended stay America, where I'm telling you all this shit went down, it's like 2 minutes up the road. Come on. This is a trafficking enclave. All right, this just came to mind. Relevant to everybody, this is huge. Write this down. You can do it right now. Do it on IG. This is how I realized it. Okay. Sick. Okay. During pandemic, they gave out business loans. They strategically designed franchises, one in particular called BU Boutique. B like the bug bee? B-E. Type in BU Boutique in Insta. You're going to see a whole list of BU Boutiques. Why? It's franchise. So, I contend that they're sex trafficking. And we have one in New Berlin. It's called BU Boutique. And there's Mayor Amen putting up the sign with these two pretty little girls in their $100 ripped jeans. As if we need a fucking boutique in the middle of a pandemic, number one. Don't you see what they do? Ladies, no, no, then let me, I'll tell you the business model is this. And the, oh, approach some ladies that just want to just sell nonsense, okay? And be fancy and they're into beauty and what they look like. Approach them. Hey, get this loan. We need a boutique. The city will support it. Oh, open up right down from the cop shop. That's a good idea. Perfect. So these ladies think they're going to put up their website and they have on their private shopping sessions. What are we doing at private shopping centers at BU Boutique? So I signed up for one and they called the cops. And the cops came to Extended Stay America to question me. And I had a note downstairs to say, if anyone comes here, they're not allowed upstairs to the third floor where there's no cameras. They let the cop right up there knock on my door. I'm like, I won't answer. I made him call me from his car and I watched him. He sat in his car, this young cop. I'm like, I had a whole video. I'm like, can I help you? He's like, we got a call from BU Boutique. I'm like, what are they worried about? Oh, this is for customer. I'm like, sir, did you do any research on anything that I'm telling you? Did you go on IG? I told him. Did you go on IG and did you see there's a BU Boutique all over the country? Really? We don't need these boutiques. People are dying. We have a bunch of people rushing in for $100 jeans right now. And your little ritual candles you're all selling? Yeah. All this shit is ritual. They were selling candles with these weird spell jar shit. They all think it's cute. Ladies, you're stupid. But my point is this. The cops don't ask them. They don't do their research. And you know what then happened? It was a young cop. He was legit trying. I said something blabbing, MK Ultra, whatever. And he goes, what's MK Ultra? Now, he stopped me in my tracks. I'm like, I said, really? And he said, yeah. And I said, okay. I'm like, you're the first cop that ever asked me. I'm kind of scared that you don't know what it is. But, and I told him about Kathy O'Brien. That's what you tell the cops. You go learn about MK Ultra. You got the damn playbook out there. Kathy O'Brien, Transformation of America, Heather Blessington, all the shit I've been through, Laura Eisenhower, all this shit. You got Laura Eisenhower being recruited to the freaking Mars Project. And I'm sitting here in Brookfield with a cop going, what's MK Ultra? And I'm excited that he's even asking. That's the dichotomy of worlds, okay? That's the dichotomy of worlds. We don't live in the world we think we do. These goons that are down here, gun-toting, filling-their-face cops, sitting around allowing this shit, and thinking they're going to get paid forever to be part of the Brotherhood. To be a bunch of sickos? You're wrong. Okay, I got to just rattle off sequence of events fast what they did, okay? So picture this. By the time I landed in Extended Stay America, Brookfield, I'm paying for a couple months. I'm trying to settle down from ripping. It's crazy, okay? I stop paying because I find them dumping. But I'm working and communicating on a regular basis with Tyler Manny, the general manager, plus investor relations, plus the local manager, okay? This is enough for them to just calm the F down, seeing that they had months on end of me paying a good faith effort. They have in writing me saying, keep my bill, put the interest on there, I'll pay whatever. We're dealing with this water issue, right? So that's important for my kids, because my son was just like, Mom, you are insane. Like, granted, it looked insane. It's like, you didn't pay your freaking bill, Mom. Like, pay it. But no. Sid, expand your thinking, okay? That was real convenient of you all to just be like, here she is, nut job again. And thanks for sending, by the way, all the times you send. You guys, while I'm at Extended Stay before this, I had 2 wellness checks from people. And they go all out in Waukesha County. So here's me. I'm 52. I'm this scrawny little lady wandering around in my sweatpants outside trying to just take a walk and relax. Four squads. Not like the cars, the trucks, the big friggin'. Are you Heather Blessington? I'm like, yep. And so the female cop gets out. You know, you can just see their whole routine. They're trained. Oh, yeah. Try to make her feel. I'm like, you want to sit down? So we sat on the grass and talked. And I thought this cop was legit. That was first time wellness. I had another one. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. So this cop, I thought she was good. She gave me her card and I called her and she blew me off. So that's where I started going. The cops are part of it. Cops are. She blew me off. I called her. Michelle somebody at the town of Brookville Police. Because after you guys did the wellness check on me, I was like, maybe I can trust her. What do I got to lose? Again, you can't be scared of anything. This is how you find the good cops. So Michelle, you're an idiot. You don't get back to me. I called her and I went in there in person. This is what it takes. You have to leave your trail of evidence with these people. I also went to city clerk office. Veronica there is fantastic. She has emails for me. I was sending her everything behind the scenes. So she has all the intel. The first time I went in there to ask about the water, after the dumping, after Tony, your water superintendent, blew me off, because this is really about the water, because you're just poisoning people to kill everybody in Brookfield. Tony blew me off. I went up there and I asked the clerk. She's the older clerk with glasses, curly hair, pale and scraggly looking. Okay, sorry, lady, but you were so freaking obvious and ridiculous. Okay, I walk in. She's typical Stepford Wives. Hi, you know, I'm going to have you to town of Brookfield. Oh, I just have questions about like town and city of Brookfield, like the difference between the two. You know, I grew up here. You know, you just play dumb, okay? Because I did grow up there and I care. My parents live up the freaking road, by the way, while this shit's going down. They just watched it all on camera. Okay, so I'm at town of Brooklyn. She's like, oh, yeah, let me show you. Rolls out the map, red carpet. Oh, yeah, so here's the town, here's the city. I'm like, all right, so how did they decide the town and the city? And just she's giving me the history and la-di-da, and the other clerks are watching. And then I'm like, well, okay, so I'm at Extended Stay America, and you know how there's a water tower up there behind me? She started rolling up the map. Started rolling up the map. You guys, I don't mess around. It was such an obvious, I hear a shift in energy like a clunk. When she started rolling the map, it was like, oop. She literally, whoop, we're done. And I looked at her, I'm like, why'd your energy change when I said water? And she was freaked. She was backing up with the scroll in her hand. I'm like, what's going on with the water, ladies? They were all looking at me. I'm like, I'll be back. Are these your cards? And then this Veronica came up. Veronica's great. Came right up, gave me all the cards. Thank you very much. Veronica, nice to meet you. I'll be back. And then, so town of Brookfield, or cops, or whoever the hell's listening, go to the town of Brookfield. You have several things to look up. Everything I emailed to Veronica direct, and I gave her permission to share everything with her captain. In fact, I asked her to. And in the story I'm going to tell you, after this occurred, I called her and said, Veronica, I had a whole situation. All I want to tell you is please ask your captain to watch the tapes. And she told me, she said, what happened? And I said, the town of Brookfield was there, the city of Brookfield was there, Waukesha County Sheriff and New Berlin was there. And she said, well, why am I only dealing with town? I'm like, I know, but I'm in the town, so I assume you're the one I call and you're the only one I freaking know and trust. So she has all of it. And the captain should have looked at that and blew a freaking gasket. Of course he didn't. Because they're all a bunch of sickos. She told me, though, she was able to look in there, and I want to say the town cop that was on it, she didn't know him or something. She'll have the notes, and I'm sure you guys recorded the phone call or emails or whatever. It was like she didn't know the person, the main culprit. Ironically, this is so freaking weird. I mean, if this ends up being a thing. In the story I'm telling, the cop that was the worst looked exactly like Joseph Garza, the superintendent of New Berlin. Like, could have been his brother. Garza's a big, overweight Hispanic dude. Okay? Looks kind of jolly, but it just close up like total dick. You're just like, exactly like ours. I'm like, what are the chances of this shit? You guys, even when the stuff was going down, yeah, I was scared. And this was the most traumatizing moment of my life. And I better tell it because I don't know how much time I have. I've never had a cop run in. I've never dealt with any of this. Okay. I'm in the room. It's my mother's birthday, April 14th, not random. I already know they delivered a thing for a hearing that was fake. So I went on the Waukesha thing to look up my hearing. It's not in there. I call the two phone numbers for my hearing. This is before the eviction started. The phone numbers don't go anywhere. So I'm like, what am I going to do? I have a hearing, and I'm thinking, I'm like, it's going to cause more problems. So I recorded a video with the hearing paperwork for the judge. It was the judge's name. I was like, this is MK Ultra. And on the paperwork was Amundson, which was my dad's handler from American Family. He was American Family agent his whole life. And Carl Amundson would come to our house. He was some huge German something. Freaking scary. Looked like Frankenstein. Amundson is on my paperwork. So this is pre-eviction, right? I'm thinking, I can just tell them my story. I'm trying to figure out the water. Then I'll pay these losers. Here, look at my 3 months of bills that I paid just fine. This is a legit tenant complaint, okay? But it's not in the Waukesha system, and you want me to just show up at your courthouse where Afritamian is? The judge? No. Nope. That sounds like a trap to me. So I recorded the whole thing for the judge. And then I sent it somewhere. I can't remember. I sent it to whatever ad or something. And Waukesha are like, here's my thing. There was no thing for me to call in. I don't know what this is. I'm targeted individual. Here's my testimony. Let me know. So I think it was fake. Why wasn't it in their system? Why didn't your phone numbers work? Who does this shit? So that's why they were able to evict me. So I'm sleeping. Get woken up in my pajamas. Out of bed. And it's Heather. I'm like, oh shit. I was like, oh. I was scared. I was freaking scared. I go to the window. I look out. I'm like, oh my God. There was at least 4 to 6 big trucks there. New Berlin, Waukesha Sheriff, and Town of Brookfield. I don't know if I saw City of Brookfield, but I think City was there too. So I won't open the door. I'm yelling through the door, and it's a female cop, Wittig. And she's like, Heather, you gotta... I'm like, ma'am, you don't know what's going on. I'm trying to explain, right? So I open the window. I start yelling out the window. I start praying out the window. They're like, we're going to break down the door, the whole thing. Okay? So I go in the bathroom. And then I'm thinking, should I get in the bathtub? I'm like, no, that'll be totally embarrassing. What if they have cameras? It's like, no. So I just sit in there till they break down the door. So I'm literally in an outfit like this. T-shirt, no bra, no shoes. I just got out of bed. Hair all over the place. I'm just like, whatever. Hadn't eaten, drank anything, whatever. Again, I'm disabled. I may not look at it like it, but I go downhill fast, okay? So they take me out in the hall, handcuffed. 6 cops. I open the door. I have the camera in their face. I'm like, oh my God. I look at Whitting, the woman. A woman in front with 5 huge cops in masks behind her. I looked at him, I'm like, you guys don't even have badges on. I'm like, who are you? I'm like, take your mask on. You don't need masks on. They would not take them off. I'm like, I look at Whitting, I'm like, so they put the girl in front? Are you this dumb? Really? She's realizing midstream, what the F is this? This is not what I thought this was. Who is this lady, right? I have a whole apartment set up, you guys. Like, really nice. I was like, so these demons pack up all your shit while they detain you in the truck. So I'm picturing these demons touching all my stuff. They're like, great. I'm like, I was just like, what is going on? They take me in the hall, handcuff me. Emily, the manager, is filming it, laughing. Like this. She's one of those girls that like flips her hair. She's giggling. I'm like, oh my God. I was just like, I've never been around this demonic energy, really. So the cop's a total dick. They're pulling my arm deliberately hard, just being assholes. And I'm the whole time going, are you proud of what you do? Do you have any idea what's going on here? Do you have any idea how you just, what a fate? I'm just talking the whole way down. I get downstairs. By this time, I'm freezing. They put me in big fat Garza brother truck. Okay? He comes in. By this point, I'm like this. I have handcuffs on. Okay? My nose is running. I'm going like this. I'm like, can I have a sip of water? Garza's brother comes in. Okay. A random video just started playing. Whatever, I stopped it. Who cares? Fat Garza's brother comes in. He says, he doesn't even look at me. I'm like, can I have a sip of water? And I see Wittig out there. He just I can see his profile. He's laughing at me, but I can see the camera and I'm making sure I'm on the camera. He turns up the radio. I'm like, I don't want that on. He turns up the radio, grabs his coffee cup, and goes out, slams the door, doesn't give me a sip of water, and butts his butt up against the truck like this so it moves, you know? And these two stand outside the door. They're back against the window, laughing and talking. And Whitting comes around with water for me and gives me water, and I look at her. I'm like, what's going on? I'm like, they put you out front. I mean, I'm telling her. So this is their system, what they do. They packed up all my stuff with Eagle moving to Milwaukee. They're totally freaking part of the cabal. You guys are sick. I was so nice to you gentlemen down there, and you're all freaking part of it. I'm just how dumb I am, okay? I'm thanking these guys for smashing all my shit. So they pack up all your stuff in boxes as if it's nice, and when you open the boxes, all your shit's smashed. There's nothing you can do. They take my car down to Milwaukee, all my stuff. I have to pay to get my car out, pay to get my boxes out, thousand, whatever it was. Have to take cabs or whatever down there I did. And then I get all my stuff, I open it up. There's $5,000 in missing items. This is after I've lost my home, I've lost everything. This is all I have. I had a necklace with a little charm from my daughter that said, "Happy first Mother's Day, Mommy. Love, Grace." Necklace. And something from my grandma from Rome. And they stole that necklace. I had a little folder that was tucked in a bin with all my child trafficking stuff. Okay? A big plastic Walmart bin. All my child trafficking evidence from a year. Okay? I had on top of it a scarf and I was using it as a table. Okay? They took that off of there. They went in that bin. It's a little red zippered pouch. My kids will know what it is. I keep all their letters and cards and stuff in there. And it was urinated on. Then I had this salt in a thing from WooFoo Movement TV. Some of you guys might know him. They threw his ass in jail. He sent me sea salt because that's how you get rid of reptilians. He's teaching me all this shit, and I had this salt and this thing with these feathers sticking out. I look at the salt, it's all yellow. Like they peed in there too. They're director, they know. They knew energetically, they know. So they stole that. Then I had legit medicine they stole. I'm a medicine woman. Okay, so I had California poppy in a jar. It's for severe pain, tooth pain, for helping opioid addicts get off opioids that the freaking government. Yeah, a whole jar, totally legal. It's freaking California poppy, stole. What'd you guys do? Sit around and love my poppy juice that night? This is what goes down. So I get all my stuff, they urinate on my stuff, and then my passport's gone. So I have two passports. One's expired. I have the expired one. They took the non-expired, and here's the freaky thing. You guys, I couldn't believe this. I have my old passport, right? So they knew. They know I'm the Epstein thing. They know. But Epstein's just, honestly, Epstein's like over here to me. I know that's a big part of it. To have me be that on top of all this shit, whatever. They're idiots. You guys, I looked at my passport. It has 444. It starts with 444. And I just chose that number for my name. I had no idea. That's the kind of stuff God does so you know, like, we're here. There's no way. There's no way this stuff is random. So anyway, I'm in the thing. They're like, "We're done detaining you." And she says, "Fat Garza's brother is going to drive you down to McDonald's to call somebody." I'm like, "I'm not going in that dude's truck. Are you kidding?" Like, "Oh, thanks, Wittig." I'm like, "Can't you drive me?" She's like, "No." I'm like, "No." She's like, "All right." And then he comes and he goes, "We'll just have you walk." They send me out, no coat. Here's the kicker. Wittig brings me clothes. I'm like, "I need warmer clothes. I'm freezing. You guys are just gonna send me out." You guys, she grabs a green, bright green sweatshirt from Eisenhower High School, my daughter's tennis sweatshirt. It was a bright neon green with a pink scarf. Okay? That of all the clothes you could grab, you're gonna grab a bright green sweatshirt and a pink scarf. Why? Because that's my MK Ultra colors. It's the preppy quote. Remember the preppy colors? That's the colors. That was an MK Ultra program. I'm gonna end with this 27 say. Lady Gaga. It's the Lady Gaga, Demi Lovato. It's a thing. Okay? That's why they gave me that. I'll be back because I'm going to finish the end of this.